behind releasing a widely disputed, deeply divisive, bitterly resisted four-page document accusing misconduct by the people running the Russia investigation. Many of them, by the way, Republicans. Some of the key figures appointed by the president himself. How does this memo put out by House Intelligence Chairman Devin Nunes track with the facts that we know? What, if anything, does it omit, blur, or distort? How much of it is even news? Does it make the case that its author and, most importantly, the president are claiming it does?
I think it's terrible. You want to know the truth? I think it's a disgrace. What's going on in this country, I think it's a disgrace. The memo was sent to Congress. It was declassified. Congress will do whatever they're going to do. But I think it's a disgrace what's happening in our country. And when you look at that and you see that and so many other things, what's going on, a lot of people should be ashamed of themselves, and much worse than that.
The president today on the memo he wanted released, according to the Washington Post, before he had a chance to read it. The one that, according to our own reporting, he has been telling friends would discredit the entire Russia investigation. But before going down that road, you should know the key items in the memo itself. The major complaint centers on the FISA surveillance court warrant obtained back in October of 2016 for ex-Trump foreign policy campaign advisor Carter Page. Now, the memo alleges that recently departed Deputy FBI Director Andrew McCabe told the House Intelligence Committee that no warrant would have been sought without the Steele dossier information. Now, that wording, sought and information, jumps out, and we'll explore the significance of that tonight. Christopher Steele, as you know, was hired by Fusion GPS, which was initially hired to do opposition research on candidate Trump by a conservative media outlet, then was later hired by the DNC and lawyers for the Clinton campaign. Now, the memo alleges that in neither the initial FISA filing nor three subsequent renewal applications was the Clinton connection disclosed, even though, according to the memo, this was known to senior FBI and Justice Department officials. Democrats say the judge was told there was a political connection. Officials identified in the memo as signing one or more of those FISA applications include fired Deputy Attorney General Sally Yates, Dana Bente, who, by the way, was just hired as the new FBI General Counsel, fired FBI Director James Comey, departed Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, and the current Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein. The implication that all of these officials, key officials, including the one currently overseeing the Russia investigation, Rod Rosenstein, acted in bad faith targeting Carter Page by not revealing who was paying Fusion GPS. Now, first, if you look at the case law, it's not actually clear they had to. Now, that aside, keeping them honest, by October 2016, Page had already left the Trump campaign. And keeping them honest, as CNN has been reporting for months now, Carter Page was, by 2016, already no stranger to U.S. counterintelligence, something the Democratic vice chair of the Intelligence Committee underscored this evening in the Situation Room.
There's a lot that the FBI knew about Carter Page that had nothing to do with Christopher Steele's reporting. Carter Page had come to the attention of the FBI, indeed, years before he joined the Trump campaign in connection with a Russian intelligence network operating in New York, in which Carter Page was very much a target.
On top of that, FISA warrants have to be renewed and a case be made for renewing them every 90 days. The court renewed this one three times. And even if you believe everything the memo alleges about bias with respect to Carter Page, all of it, he was not even the spark for the Russia investigation. How do we know that? It's in the memo. The memo itself says the FBI launched a counterintelligence investigation on George Papadopoulos in July of 2016. Papadopoulos, another Trump campaign foreign policy advisor, pleaded guilty to lying about contacts with Russians and is now cooperating with special counsel Robert Mueller. So the FBI was all in on possible Trump campaign Russia connections months before asking for a warrant on Carter Page. So if the memo was designed to discredit the genesis of the Russia investigation, that notion itself discredited by the memo itself. And even setting that aside, it's being criticized for more than just internal inconsistency. The FBI, run by the president's hand-picked director, a Republican, says the document is marred by, quote, omissions of fact that fundamentally impact the memo's accuracy. A leading and highly respected member of the president's own party, the Republican standard bearer, just a decade ago, goes beyond even that. The statement from John McCain is frankly scathing. The latest attacks against the FBI and Department of Justice serve no American interests, no parties, no presidents, only Putin's. He goes on, the American people deserve to know all the facts surrounding Russia's ongoing efforts to subvert our democracy, which is why Special Counsel Mueller's investigation must proceed unimpeded. He concludes our nation's elected officials, including the president, must stop looking at this investigation through the lens of politics and manufacturing political sideshows. If we continue to undermine our own rule of law, we are doing Putin's job for him. Yet for all the sound and fury, for all the buildup surrounding this memo, for all the distrust it sows of institutions and officials who were formerly held in high esteem by Republicans and Democrats alike, others argue that the bottom line is just how little substance there really is. James Comey, the fired FBI director, tweeted, "That's it? Dishonest and misleading memo wrecked the House Intel Committee, destroyed trust with intelligence community, damaged relationship with FISA Court, and inexcusably exposed classified investigation of an American citizen. For what? DOJ and FBI must keep doing their jobs." Keeping them honest, whatever you think of James Comey or his decisions or his firing and subsequent testimony, whatever else you think, those two words, for what, go straight to the heart of it. And perhaps the best answer we have comes tonight from the one person who can act on the memo that he himself so badly wanted out there.